In summary, I would give this engine slightly below average remarks for reliability. Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the most common BMW N53 engine problems and reliability. Unfortunately, there are quite a few different issues to discuss with the BMW N53 engine. It actually shares much of its design with the similar BMW N52 engine. However, the N53 does use direct fuel injection rather than port injection, and it shares many of those fueling components with the BMW N54 engine, much of which was known to be very problematic, especially in the earlier days of both the N53 and N54. So unfortunately, that direct injection fueling system is a source of a number of common issues on the BMW N53, but just wanted to point that out up front, since throughout the video I will reference the N52 and N54 a few times, since the N53 is a little bit of a hybrid between these two engines. But with that said, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss some of the most common BMW N53 engine problems. Number one on the list, jumping straight in with the fuel system issues, we have high pressure fuel pump failure on the N53. So this is the same exact high pressure fuel pump that was used on the BMW N54 engine, and one that was known to be extremely problematic in the early days of these engines. It really took BMW up until about 2011 to fully remedy the high pressure fuel pump issues. So it took quite a few redesigns of the high pressure fuel pump to actually get a working design and something that has remained fairly reliable for the longer term. So this is more so of an earlier issue for the BMW N53. Pretty much the newest pumps from 2011 plus are pretty reliable. And ultimately by the mid 2010s, a lot of these old faulty fuel pumps had already failed or been recalled and been replaced with the newest, much less problematic high pressure fuel pump. So nowadays, this isn't really a significant issue, just something to be aware of, because there may be a few of those older high pressure fuel pumps on the N53 still floating out there somewhere. And otherwise, high pressure fuel pump failures still can happen with these newest pumps, just a lot less common than back in the day where these failures were popping up as early as 5, 10, 20,000 miles. Most of the new designs seem to hold up well past 100,000 miles. So not really a major issue nowadays. Again, just something to be aware of, since that was something that really plagued both the BMW N53 and N54 frequently in the earlier days of these engines. Moving on to number two, much like the high pressure fuel pump issues, another common problem with the BMW N53 is the fuel injectors. Now, these are the same piezoelectric injectors that the BMW N54 uses. And the downside with the piezoelectric injectors is they're incredibly expensive due to their complexity. They're not often found on most gasoline engines, especially not production gasoline engines, which is why BMW later switched to a solenoid style injector like on the BMW N55 engine. But ultimately, these piezoelectric injectors were another part that gave BMW countless issues in the earlier days of the N53 and N54. They even got to the point of making index 12 injectors, which are the latest iteration. They do go from index 1 all the way up to 12. So it took BMW that many iterations to really get a bulletproof and reliable fuel injector for these engines. The downside to that is the index 12 are going to be the most reliable and really the best fuel injector for these engines, but nowadays they cost somewhere in the $2,500 to $3,500 ballpark to replace all six injectors. So if you do run into injector problems and want to replace them with the newest, highest quality component, you're looking at a pretty chunky repair bill there for that, just in the cost of the parts alone. So really just one of those issues that is unfortunate. If you are shopping for a used N53 and you find one that has index 12 fuel injectors, then that's definitely a big find and a big win, since again, those do tend to be highly reliable and don't very frequently run into any problems. The easy way to check and tell that is if you pull off the engine cover and look at the injectors, it will actually have the index on the side of the injector. It'll have the part number and then a dash and that final number, -11-12. That will be the index of that injector. Moving on to common problem number three for the BMW N53 inline six engine, we have issues with the NOx or NOx sensors, as well as the NOx catalytic converter. So the N53 is a stratified charge engine. Ultimately, stratified charge engines have a much higher NOx emissions than a standard gasoline engine, which is why BMW then installed the NOx catalytic converter and sensor. Unfortunately, both of those parts tend to be common problems on the N53, especially as these engines continue aging and getting older and older. The sensor is relatively inexpensive and a pretty straightforward fix. However, the catalytic converter, on the other hand, is fairly expensive. So that can be a serious issue if you run into that. And there are a couple aftermarket solutions if you do run into that issue. So a couple solutions that can help you bypass that issue. But just something to be aware of, because these NOx sensor and cat issues are really two of the more common problems on the BMW N53. Moving on to common problem number four for the BMW N53 engine, clumping together water pump failures and other cooling system problems. This is really going to be something that's shared among pretty much any N-series engine of the same era. The N52, the N53, N54, N55 are all prone to pretty frequent water pump issues as well as problems with much of the rest of the cooling system. So it is an electric water pump on these engines, and that tends to fail every 50 to 100,000 miles. There isn't really a long-term solution for this. Part of what fails is the composite impeller. And so some people have tried designing aftermarket water pumps that use a metal impeller, but that heavier metal impeller then puts more stress on the pump electrically, and so they end up failing electrically rather than something with the impeller. Unfortunately, there really isn't just a long-term proven an effective solution for the water pump failures. Outside of that, the coolant expansion tank, the radiator, the cooling fan, and coolant hoses are all known to run into issues, especially in the 80 to 120,000 mile ballpark. And especially now, considering all of these N53s are roughly 11 to 17 year old engines on the road today, chances are if you own the N53 for the longer term, you'll probably run into at least a couple of these different cooling system issues between water pump, coolant expansion tank, cooling fan, radiator, and coolant hoses. Moving on to problem number five for the BMW N53, and that is going to be oil leaks. So the oil filter housing gasket, valve cover gasket, and oil pan gasket are going to be some of the more common oil leaks. Much like the cooling system problems, roughly every 80 to 120,000 miles is where some of these issues start popping up. You might not run into all three of them, but again, chances are you'll run into at least a couple of these oil leaks, especially given the age and mileage of most N53s on the road nowadays. Just another thing to be on the lookout for. And if you're looking to pick up a used N53, check for oil leaks, look under the vehicle, let it run for a little bit, park it in one spot. Just make sure there aren't any oil stains or burning oil smells, like in the case of the valve cover gasket, which often leads to burning oil smells rather than an actual visible leak on the ground. May not be fair to truly consider them common issues, since oftentimes they really are just more so related to age, mileage, and wear and tear on those rubber gaskets, O-ring seals, etc. Last but not least, moving into problem number six for the BMW N53, we have carbon buildup. Now, this is another thing that's shared with the BMW N54. Due to the design of the engine being direct injection, all engines produce some natural oil blow-by, which makes its way back into the intake tract and sticks to the back of intake ports and valves. On a traditional port injection engine like the BMW N52, you actually have fuel spraying into those valves, which will wipe away any deposits and really keep those valves nice and clean. However, with direct injection engines, there's no fuel, there are no detergents being sprayed over those valves. So over time, that oil hardens and causes carbon buildup or carbon deposits. And that can start creating a number of drivability issues, since that does start restricting airflow into the cylinders. So you might notice power loss, rough idle, misfires, stuttering, hesitation, quite a few different symptoms with that. And really the ultimate solution is just walnut blasting the intake valves and ports, generally every 80,000 to 100,000 miles. That is good maintenance. Just a downside of having a direct injected engine, especially in the earlier days of direct injection technology when it was just starting to become increasingly more popular. And again, this was really BMW's first round with modern direct injection engines. Anyway, that wraps up the most common problems for the BMW N53 engine. In summary, I would give this engine slightly below average remarks for reliability. Compared to BMWs of the same era, it's probably still slightly below average, ultimately a bit less reliable than the BMW N52. I wouldn't say it's quite as bad as the BMW N54, of course, since that has a twin turbochargers and a number of other issues that were prevalent due to the turbo design. So maybe not quite as bad as the N54, but certainly less reliable and a little bit more complicated of an engine than the BMW N50. Unfortunately, again, with the N53, just part of what brings it down is the fact that some of those fuel system issues can be incredibly expensive, like the fuel injectors. If you really want the most effective, long-term, most reliable fix, those index 12 injectors are just extremely expensive. Same with the NOx catalytic converter. If you run into issues with that, that's just an expensive problem. And then throw in some of the more age-related maintenance items and things that tend to go bad with age, like the cooling system, oil leaks, etc. And the N53 can be a fairly problematic engine. Now, that's not to say all is bad. We own a number of N54s, which again, I would generally say is less reliable than the N53. And that doesn't necessarily mean they're reliability nightmares. We've actually had good experiences for the most part with our BMW N54s. They do just require a little bit of extra maintenance here and there and maybe a weekend out in the garage. So ultimately, if you're somewhat knowledgeable and hands-on with DIYs, then really an N53 can be a great engine to own. But if you're going to be taking it to a repair shop for every little problem that pops up, then you might consider avoiding the BMW N53 engine. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more. Thanks, everyone.